Are you looking for a way to speed up your Power Apps development process and provide a consistent look and feel in the controls you use? Well, you should check out the new Microsoft Power Apps Creator Kit. I'll break down what's included in this and how to install it right after this. This Creator Kit was released just a couple weeks ago, and it was a group effort from several community members like Scott Duro and the Microsoft team in getting this released. And really what it is just packaging up several pieces of functionality and components that already existed into an easy-to-use managed solution. And everything that's included in here is meant to speed up your app development process and help you get a consistent look and feel in some of the components used. So as part of this solution, you'll get a component library that has some sample controls and Power Apps component framework controls built by the community in Microsoft to be able to use in your applications. And all the components in this use what's called the Fluent UI. So you might have noticed this in all the Office applications and on Microsoft Teams, that consistent look and feel that you have, it's because it uses the Fluent UI framework. So if you want to add that same consistent look and feel in your Power Apps, this Creator Kit gives you several components that utilize that, as well as a Fluent UI theme generator. So to get started, we'll go here to this website, which I will provide a link in the video description, and you'll see this download option. So you're going to download this, and it's a managed solution file. Once you have that managed solution file uploaded, you'll go to make.powerapps.com and make sure that you're in an environment where you can upload and edit solutions. So we'll go over here to the left rail and we'll select the solutions tab and the import solution option. We'll click browse and we'll navigate to that managed solution for the creator kit that we just downloaded. So select that and click next. So we'll click import and that will add in this managed solution into our environment so we can start using some of the components of this new creator kit. So it looks like that solution imported successfully. So we'll go open up and click in the solution and see what we get. So as you can see, we get quite a bit with this creator kit. Now the main things that I want to focus on is the Fluent UI theme editor, the creator kit reference app, and the component library. So scrolling down here, starting with this reference app. So we're going to click on this reference app and click play, and we'll see what we get. This app is really great for showing us some best practices for creating well-designed applications and even giving us the code to use inside of our Power Apps. Now, the first thing we see right off the bat is it's showing us a pattern to be able to do an auto width for a label. So especially when we're wanting to do things like responsive design, these auto width capabilities really are important. So this actually shows us how we would use this. We can see that we have a label here with some text, and next to the text, maybe right after it, we want to show an emoji. And we want to dynamically change the width of this label based off of the number of characters in this particular label. So we have a slider that we can shrink down the number of words, and you see as we move that slider down that the width automatically scales down accordingly and that icon is still showing to the right. So this pattern, we can see how it's used in the app, but we can also click on this button on the right to get the code to make that happen, to actually repeat this pattern in an app that we're building. There is so much that you can learn from this reference application alone. Lots of good patterns represented here. I really like this commands, menus, and nav section. If we expand that here a bit, we have a pattern highlighted here for creating a breadcrumb in our applications. Now I like how it clearly lists out the do's and the don'ts. So in this case with the breadcrumb, we want to use that on top of a page, above a list of items, things like that, but not use it as a primary way to navigate in your application. So again, we see the demonstration of how this would look in an app, but then we can click on the code tab and get the actual PowerFX formula needed to make this happen and reproduce this in an app that you're building. I'm not going to go over everything in this reference app with the fine-tooth comb, just wanted to show some highlights here. Another thing I really like is this picker section. Another great pattern that I use a lot in applications that I build for adding a custom control for selecting information. So rather than relying, say, on some of the out-of-the-box components, like the drop-down control, the combo box, creating your own basic tag list and being able to see how many tags that you have selected. So again, seeing this in practice, how it would look, say, in a gallery, and even being able to do things like rounding the tag, so changing the styling and even adding icons, and having that produce the code for you. So this would be the first thing I would check out. The second thing from the creator kit I would look at is the Fluent Theme Designer. So if we play this application, we'll see what we have here. So again, the Fluent UI theme is used throughout the Office suite. So this is just making it easier for us to replicate that same look and feel in our Canvas applications. So we can see here on the right, a live preview of what the styles that we have selected will look like. And on the left, we can change things like our primary, text, and background color. So say maybe I wanted to have a dark mode application. I can change this background color by clicking on the box here and drag my color picker to a black color, for example. And I can see as soon as I do that real time that it's updating what it will look like. I obviously know that the text that I have there isn't working with the black color, so I probably need to go into the text color and maybe change that to a white and possibly change my primary color here too, maybe to something a little bit brighter so it will stand out. So I have a real-time preview of my theme and how it will look on a bunch of different controls like drop-downs, radio buttons, sliders, and all that. And the really cool thing about this is it has a built-in accessibility checker, so I can make sure whatever theme that I'm building is accessible. So I can see that everything looks good, it's passing the contrast ratio and all of that, so I have an accessible theme. Now if I'm ready to use it, I can export this, and it gives me a code block that I can put in my app OnStart to use these themes throughout my application. So this is a pattern I've actually showed in some of my previous videos for creating a branding screen. So in the app OnStart, we define our styles and we can reference those styles in our custom theme throughout our application. So I will put a link to the video where I show how to implement this branding approach in your applications. But what this Fluent UI Theme Designer is doing is it's cutting down on the need for us to manually create those styles. We can simply run through this Fluent UI Theme Generator, get everything looking how we want, and copy this code block here to have our color palette that we can reference throughout our app. Now, finally, let's take a look at that component library that we get as part of this kit. So to see what we get with this component library as part of the creator kit, we're gonna go back to make.powerapps.com, select the apps tab from the left rail, and we'll have this component libraries option. And in here, you should see this PowerCat component library that we get as part of that creator kit. So we can click on that and that will open up the component library app and we can see what it gives us. So as you can see, quite a few components that we can plug and play from this library inside of our PowerApps applications. First thing that you're seeing here is a spinner control. So these controls are not really anything new. They've been around in the GitHub repo for a while where we can manually download and import those. This creator kit is just giving us a convenient package of all these assets in one place. I've used the spinner component in quite a few of my applications. You've heard me talk about performance a lot in my videos when it comes to creating PowerApps and how important it is to always be communicating with your users. So if you have some kind of long running process, making sure that you put something like one of these spinner loading messages up so that the user knows that the app is working. So really good control to use for that. So some of the other components it gives us is this really nice expandable menu component, a header component, a dialogue component, search box, custom icon, a panel, which kind of mimics a panel that we get like when we're doing model-driven apps, how we can have that right-hand side panel. We can mimic that here in our Canvas apps, and a progress indicator. So this shows us the components themselves. Now, what if we want to use one of these components that we get as part of this kit? Well, we can open up a power app that we already have built here, and we'll select this plus button on the left-hand side. And at the very bottom, you see this Get More Components option. So if we open that up, we'll actually see here is our component library from that creator kit. So we can actually expand this out and see all the different components that we have as part of that. So if I wanted to use the expand menu component, I'd simply select that from this list. And the cool thing is I can select multiple at a time. So if I wanted to use that and say maybe the header or the progress indicator, I can select all of those and add them at one time into my app to use. So I'll select import there and it's gonna load those components into the app. Now that those are added into my app, you'll see on the left-hand side, we have a new section called library components. And if I expand that out, there are the three components that we imported from that component library. So I can simply select, say, this expand menu component, and that will add that onto this screen. So now I have a left nav menu, if I play the application, that I can click through, and all I have to do is wire this up to the different pages I might have in my app to allow me to navigate between the different screens. Now, what we saw from the component library, though, are just the Canvas components that we get. Now, there's two different types of components, which I've talked about before. We have Canvas components that we build in the maker experience of Power Apps itself, but we also have code components that are built in Visual Studio or VS Code. So this kit also includes some code components that we can use. Now, to get to those, we're going to go to that plus icon and go back to our Get More Components option. And you might have noticed at the top here, we have Canvas and we have this code option as well. So if we select that, we'll see all the different code components that we get as part of this creator kit. So you might have remembered when we were looking at that reference application, I showed an example of a tag list. That's actually a Power Apps component framework code component that's a part of this kit. So we can select this Fluent tag list component and import. And now again, when we add a code component into our application, we'll see a new section for code components in our tree view here, and we can select the Fluent tag list. So these code components give us more flexibility and more power, no pun intended. Now I have this code component in my application. I can have a simple tag list. All I have to do is bind it to a choice of items. So we see on the right-hand side, we have a properties panel that we can configure this code component. And there we see our tag list, and all we'd have to do is bind that to a data source that had the list of items that we want to be able to pick from. So lots of cool functionality included in this creator kit. Hopefully this gave you a pretty good overview of what's included and how to get started using some of this functionality. Have you used this creator kit? If so, drop it in the comments and let me know what your favorite feature is or what you'd like to see added. And that's all that I have for you today, but if you enjoyed this video, check out some of the other videos that I have on Power Apps. And do me a big favor, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button too. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.